Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to set up Fluentd as a sidecar to collect or analysis the application logs that is hosted on Kubernetes cluster environment. There are two types of the application. One is cloud native application and second is legacy application. The cloud native application write their logs as standard error or standard out, and these logs can access by using kubectl logs and container name. There are many logs libraries available and developer can use these libraries to write the application logs as a standard error or standard output. Whereas legacy application doesn't write their logs as a standard error or standard output. They write their application logs on local volume. For example, legacy application is hosted on Tomcat server. The Tomcat server will write the logs on var logs tomcat access.log. We will deploy both kind of the application and collect the logs in Kibana dashboard. Let's begin. To demonstrate cloud native application, I am using a example guestbook application. This application uses PHP as a front end, Redis as a database backend service. I am using this deployment file to deploy the PHP guestbook application on Kubernetes environment. I will upload this deployment file on my GitHub account. You can download for your demonstration. This is standard deployment file. I am using the ingress resource for this application and this is hostname of this application. Let's go ahead and deploy the application on the cluster. I am creating a separate namespace for the guestbook application. Now I am deploying guestbook application in guestbook namespace. All required deployment or services has been created. Let's verify the ports. All the required ports are running. Let's get a list of ingress controller. Let's describe the front end ingress resource. We can access the application by this host name. Since I am using the ingress, hence I can point guestbook.example.com to any Kubernetes node. I am pointing the guestbook.example.com to 171, one of the node in a Kubernetes cluster. Let's try to access the application. Yes, we can access the application on the browser. Let's do some of the application transaction. Since this is the cloud native application, hence this application should write the logs as a standard out or standard error. We should able to access the application logs from one of the Kubernetes ports. Let's try to access the application logs from this port. Yes, we can access the application logs as standard error or standard out from Kubernetes port. Let's try to access these application logs in Kibana dashboard. This is my Kibana dashboard. Go to discover. Let's go ahead and search logs for guestbook application. And you can see logs for guestbook.example.com. We can see 200 success code. You can see the container name from which logs are generating. All the logs are generating from general D, has a standard error or standard output. This is for cloud native application that writes the logs, has a standard error or standard output. But what about the legacy application that doesn't write the logs, has a standard error or standard output? Let's demonstrate. For the legacy application, I am deploying a simple HTML project on Nginx web server. This is the deployment file. I will upload this file on my GitHub account. You can download for testing. Let's go ahead and deploy it. I am creating my application in Sidecar namespace. My application has been deployed. I am using the ingress controller for my application deployment, and I can access my application by using sidecar.example.com. I am pointing the host name of the application to the one of the Kubernetes worker node. Let's try to access the application on the browser. Yes, I can access the application. Let's try to pull down application logs from Nginx web server like we did for guestbook application. Kubectl logs are empty because our application is writing logs on local volume. Let's connect this container. We are inside the container. Application writing the logs under Nginx folder. So what is the solution to pull down these application logs on Kibana dashboard? We will implement a sidecar concept here to pull down these application logs. Let's implement. We are going to use this deployment file to implement the sidecar container along with the application container. I am creating a separate namespace for this deployment. I am using the ingress controller for this application. This is important part of this file. We are using the config map to copy fluentd.conf file. We are using the tell plugins to read the Nginx logs. This is the path of the log file, and this is the tag nginx.access for the Nginx logs, and the format will be Nginx, and this is the condition match nginx.access. It is going to match nginx.access tag and send all the logs as a standard out or standard error so that kubectl can read all the logs. We are deploying two containers in the deployment section, one for application container, and we are mounting this path on the container. It is a special kind of volumes called mtdir. We will attach mtdir volume to fluentd container also. Now Nginx web server will write the logs in this location, and this is mounted on mtdir volume so that fluentd container can read the logs from the mtdir mounted volume. We are using the fluentd Debian image, and we are mounting or attaching config map to the fluentd sidecar container. I will upload this file on my GitHub account. You can download for your demonstration. This is the service section for the deployment. Let's go ahead and deploy. I am going to deploy application along with the sidecar in a separate namespace called sidecar. application has been deployed. You can see here ports are ready. Let's verify the containers in the pod. Two containers are running in this pod. One is Nginx and second is Fluentd. Let's try to connect Fluentd container. We are trying to connect Fluentd container in this pod for the sidecar namespace. Let's connect it. Can we access Nginx logs from Nginx container? Let's try it. Yes, we can access Nginx access logs in our sidecar container. Let's verify the Fluentd configuration file. Yes, Fluentd configuration file successfully copied on the container. You need to deploy all the configuration file in this location. Let's get out from this container. Let's try to pull down the logs from the sidecar containers. And now you can see here, we can successfully access application logs in a side container by using kubectl. It means that side containers is reading application logs from Nginx web server, has a standard error or standard out. Let's verify these logs in Kibana dashboard. These are indexes in Elasticsearch. This is my Kibana dashboard. Go to discover. Go ahead and search logs for sidecar application. Yes, we can see the logs for the sidecar application. And you can see here, logs are generating from Fluentd sidecar container. So by using sidecar, we can pull down the logs from any container as a standard error or standard out. That's all in this video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.